negative 12 plus 5. Is that equal to negative 7?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so check for that one. Try the second one. There's 2 times 1 equals 0. Get negative 2 minus 2, which is?
Negative 4.
4.
Negative 4. Okay, so it's not 0. No. But the reason why I chose 3 and asked if it was okay with you guys is because I made a little typo in the second equation.
Uh-huh.
What could I change in the second equation so that this actually would have worked out to be a solution?
Plus
instead of minus. And so it's the plus and accidentally minus. I mean, you put no, but that was right for the one that they gave you. If I had put it right now, it would be a solution. But we also get to discuss, what does it mean to be a solution to a system? Can somebody tell me that in a few words, what it means for an ordered pair to be a solution to a system of equations?
It means that as much points as you have to have that much equations to be equal.
Oh, you're kind of talking about what a system is. What is a solution to a system, Molly?
It works for all of the equations.
For all the equations in the system, it is a solution.
Yeah.
A little check for our edits. So if this was plus, it would be plus. So what is it? Alright, so we understand, right? You ready for the review?
Yep.
Totally. Remember to show your work in the review. So we'll cut to the chase. Is 3 a solution to the system?
No.
Does it work in either one of these?
No.
Does it work in either?
One.
First one?
C.
So it works in the first one, but not the second one. So,
right.
Well, overall it's not.
That's not showing your work.
Did you ever announce to the entire class?
What?
You know which one is the solution, as long as you show your work to prove that it's the solution, that's always important.
Okay,
so 2-2, does it work in the first equation?
No.
Does it work in the second?
Yeah.
No.
Yes,
it works on the second.
Yeah. Let's take a look. Wait, 2 times 2 plus 5 times 2 times 4 plus 10.
Yeah.
Oh, I copied that down wrong. I copied that.
Okay. So it works in the second, but not the first, so that's out.
Yeah.
So the third one does work?
Yep, it has to be. Unless it's none of the above.
Unless it's none of the above, yeah. Well, let's just show our work real quick. Negative 2 times negative 3 plus 3 times 4 should be 18. Well, that's a positive 6 plus 12. And yes, it does work. 2 times negative 3 plus 5 times 4 should equal 14. Well, that's a negative 6 plus 20.
14.
Which is. Alright, we all get that. Let's have our notes out and get ready for something new. Here's my question. This combination of x and y, negative 3 for x and 4 for y, is a solution to the system.
Mm-hmm.
Correct? Both equations. Now,
mm-hmm.
Do you think, and I'm going to put it to a vote in a second, do you think that it's possible that there are more combinations, two different numbers, that also work in both equations?
No.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
Got some yeses, got some noes. Who says, let's start with maybe. Who says maybe there is?
What you say maybe and yes?
Yeah, you can vote for maybe and yes. So let's say maybe and then we'll stay if we think yes. Maybe there is another solution?
Mm-hmm.
We got two people, three, four people. Okay. Who says definitely, yeah, I would have to assume that there's got to be some solution out there other than this one. Okay? A lot of people thinking that there's got to be one. And who says, absolutely not, there's no way there's another solution. Aiden is saying, absolutely not, no way.
Just because
okay.
He can.
Well, it's kind of hard to answer if I just put it out there and we're just thinking about it. Because how many numbers are there?
Infinity.
There's so many numbers. Like, to just,
oh,
yes, and to say, like, hey, no other possible combination exists anywhere in the universe. There's no other two numbers that could solve both of these equations. Right? You might think because there's so many numbers, there's bound to be another one out there somewhere. We just have to find the right one. Okay.
Oh, I know what you mean.
Oh.
Got it.
Okay. We're gonna
do like that.
Well, let's back up for a second. If I could show you a picture of all the possible solutions for each of the equations, right? All infinity of them. Does that help?
Yeah.
Can you see
yeah.
a picture of it?
That'd be great.
So, what's the picture called? A picture of all of the solutions for each equation.
A graph.
Oh. Called a graph.
Looks like Googleplex.
So, well, they're all Googleplex solutions. It's and more than that. But the graph is exactly that. It is a picture of all the possible solutions to a particular equation.
Mm-hmm.
So let's graph both of these and we'll be able to see all of the solutions. Right? All right, to graph this first one, we could rearrange and write it in slope-intercept form, or we could say it's in standard form, and I know how to graph equations that are in standard form, right?
Right.
You can plug in a 0 for x and find y.
And you can plug in 0 for y and find x.
So if we plug in 0 for x, what would y be?
18 divided by 3 equals 6.
Okay, so it would be 6.
And then it would be -9.
Negative 9. Put a 0 in for y, that gets canceled out. Negative 2x equals 18. Divide
mm-hmm.
by negative 2. Okay, negative 9. And then 2. I got 0 for x there, 0 for y as well.
If I plug in
0 for x, what does that give me?
5y.
Y is 5y?
Oh, I know 5y equals 14.
Okay, so what is y? 14 over 5. And if I put in 0 for y, what does that give me for x? 7. Graph these, first I'll graph these red points, 0, 6, and negative 9, 0, and I'll draw a straight line with red. So, what's that?
Those are all our
solutions. Yeah, these are all the solutions, at least the ones we can see in this little window.
Mm-hmm.
We can keep going in that direction and see infinitely many more. We can that direction, see if anything anywhere that way.
Yep.
But hopefully something interesting happens in the little window we're looking at. Let's look at the blue points. Okay, we got 7, 0, that's an easy one. And 7, 0. And then 0, 14 over 5, that'd be 2.8. Okay, now, this blue line is a picture of what?
This picture of the other.
Picture of what about the second one?
Those are the solutions.
Yes, all the solutions. Any x and y that I choose, like this one, or this one, or this one, this one way up here, this one way over here. Any one that I choose, right, and I figure out what the x and the y are, and I plug that x and y into the second equation, it will make both sides equal.
Yep.
Any one that I pick from the second one, right, here, 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 here or here, this one here, any of those, figure out the x and the y of that point are, plug that x and y into the first equation, make both sides equal. Okay? Now there's one point out of all the possible points that's particularly interesting. Clint?
Oh, wait, I have a question. So how do you know which number will go with it?
We'll go with what?
Like if you pick that point there in blue, how do you know which point on red?
Well, this point on, well, this point has an x and a y. It looks like maybe it's...
Oh, so that point works, right? So
only for the blue one, right?
Right.
Oh, I see. And not for the red one.
Yeah.
But there's one that must work for the blue one and the red one. Aiden? Why? Aside from it's already written here.
Look
at that. Here's a solution. Is it on the blue line?
Yeah.
So it's a solution for the second one. Is it on the red line? And it's a solution for the first one. It's a solution for both. So I go back to my question. Do you think, other than -3, 4, do you think that other than -3, 4, that there's any other solution possible that works in both equations?
Yes.
Yes.
No.
Oliver, tell us why you think now, because you weren't chiming in with no before. So what about this graph tells you that there's just no other possible x and y that could work in this equation and this equation?
They'll only cross one time and that's on one time.
They're two straight lines. They go on straight forever in both directions, right? And they'll only cross once. They're never going to cross again. Let me remind you why this point is important, okay? It's the point -3, 4. Remember what a graph is? A graph is a picture of what? All the solutions to whatever equation that graph came from. So this is a picture of all the solutions for the second equation. There they are, all infinity of them, and more this way and more that way.
Oh, I see now. So you can't do that same number twice.
Right. There's just going to be no way that there's another point, right, that is the same x and y for the red and the blue graph. Mm-hmm. Only this one.
Danielle? Okay, so I'm going to put it, but I've kind of been struggling with this a little bit.
Okay.
And it's trying to find the slope from just the normal number. I'm not exactly sure how to do that.
What? Like,
well,
without having.
I've just been doing, for example, like 2 over 1. And I usually get it wrong.
Well, when we just did this, we didn't use the slope at all. We just found 2 points by plugging in 0 for x and 0 for y.
Oh.
But we can, we'll have some slopes here in a second. And if you still have questions, I'm glad to help you as well. Okay. So, where they cross is this place. This place has an x and a y. And this is the only x and y that is the same for the red line and the blue line. Okay, where they cross. Could some other kinds of graphs have more than one solution that works in both equations?
Yes.
And what would they have to look like?
Let's say, go back a page. Well, let's just say that wasn't a -2.
Let's just say it wasn't a -2?
Yeah, you could probably, I think it like work, or you probably have more than one solution.
Okay, so 2x plus 3y equals 18.
Yeah.
And 2x plus 5y equals 14. So you need to find more solutions?
Yeah.
All right, let's graph it and see. So again, I'm going to show you all the solutions for the first equation and show you all the solutions for the second equation and see if they might have the same equation in common. So I'll plug a 0 in for x and a 0 in for y. A 0 for x would give me 3y equals 18.
Mm-hmm.
And so y would be
4, 5, 6.
6.
There's 0 in for y, 2x equals 18, and x is going to be
9.
9. These are gonna be the same as they were before.
No, it's 7.
2.8. Oh, okay.
And 7, comma, 0.
0.
That's the same 2 points that we had before, 0 and 2.8, 7, comma, 0.
14.
So this first one is now 0, 6, and positive 9, 0 instead of negative 9, 0. So, not a line. And 0, 2.8. 7 zeros. Still stands. We change this to a positive 2, right, Glenn?
Yeah.
Does it look like there's more than one solution that works in both of these?
Oh, no. Yeah, it's kind of dense, but I don't know. No.
Okay, I want you all to pay close attention, put your hand down, listen, open your ears, okay? This graph, what is this graph made of?
Numbers.
Points. Points. It's made of points. Okay? like this point here, right?
Mm-hmm.
This point here is one of those points. It has a coordinate, right? It has coordinates. Let's see. Some point on this line, and I knew the x and y of that point, that x and that y for this particular point, if I plug it into the second equation, since this is the graph of the second equation, then it would make both sides equal, right?
Yeah.
Okay. This point would do the same, and this point would do the same, and this point would do the same, okay? And this point also, right?
Right.
This point with its x and y, whatever that x and y are, is it gonna be a solution to this equation?
Yeah.
Is it also gonna be a solution to this equation?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, because it crosses there.
Because this point is also on this line, yeah. Okay. So wherever, if we want to find a solution that works in both of these equations, then how will the graphs tell us that?
Well, it crosses.
Where it crosses. Okay, where it crosses will tell us the solution to both equations. Will these two lines cross more than once?
No.
So could there be more than one solution?
No.
There could only be one solution. Right?
Right.
So it's not like if I search forever and ever and maybe, 2.73 and negative 4.98. That's the magic other combination. There's only one combination of x and y, it could possibly work for both because there's only one that is on both of the graphs.
Okay.
Because the graph is a picture of all the solutions. It is the only solution that's on both graphs. So let's talk about that. Will they always cross? We're talking about two lines. Will two lines always cross?
No, because they could be perpendicular or parallel.
Do perpendicular lines cross?
I mean, parallel.
They can be parallel. Do parallel lines cross?
No.
So it's possible for two equations to not have a solution that works in both. Is it possible to have systems that don't have solutions?
Mm-hmm.
Is it possible for these two lines to cross any other number of times besides 1 or 0?
Once. Because there's only two different equations, so those would only have to do once.
So, only one solution or no solution?
Yeah.
No other possibility of solutions?
That's what I think.
What?
No, I'm not doing it.
If you have two lines, could they cross any different number of times besides one or zero? If you draw one line and you draw the exact same line again, how many times do those two lines cross each other?
Infinity
times. So that can happen when we have two equations that look different. It looks like the numbers are different, but it turns out they're exactly the same. And that means that like one equation is actually like two times bigger than the other one, or it's one of the equations has been multiplied by -3 and you get the other one. Let me show you a quick example of what I mean. Like if I had this equation 2x plus 3y equals 4, this other equation 4x plus 6y equals 8, it's the same equation. I just multiply both sides of this equation by 2. They're the same. If I were to graph them, I'd have all the same solutions. And so this one would have infinite solutions. But we don't have to worry about that today. We're working with systems that do have solutions. And we're going to find those solutions. Introduction to finding the solutions is by using the graphs. Okay? So we're going to graph and we're going to find what?
The solution.
How will the graphs tell us the solution?
From the line.
Where they cross.
Clint?
Wait, how do you? Oh, wait, isn't the circle has infinite solutions just because they'll be multiple of each other? Oh,
I one equation is a multiple of the other. Like this is a multiple of that one.
And that's a multiple of that one.
This is a multiple of that one?
Is that the only, is it only one side that's multiple of the multiple?
No, both sides.
Oh.
Like I took this side and multiplied by 2 and this side and multiplied by 2 and I got this equation.
Oh, I see.
If you do that, like any equation that works in here, it's definitely gonna work in here. Just multiplying by 2.
Okay. I kind of spaced out there.
It's all gonna work. That's right. Infinite solution and no solutions for the day.
Well, I don't understand what it is. But what happens if you have a number that it has like 2x plus 9 on home? And then that other one is y equals 6.
Oh, I'm not going to do your homework.
I know, but can you do something like it?
I'm going to do what I do, and if you still have questions, then you can ask those questions. Okay. Good question, Oliver?
Kind of.
Like on our homework? Nope. I'm going to continue on with class, and if you have a question on the homework, okay. I'm not. If you choose to do this, I don't erase this before you come in, but I'm also not going stand up here and just answer one more question. Okay. So if you want to ask me questions, then I'm going to ask me questions about what I'm doing up here currently. So our strategy is going to be to graph and find the intersection of the graphs. So our first example, I'm going to make it pretty easy on us. Y equals -3/2 x minus 2 y equals x plus 3. So we're going to find the solution by graphing and finding where they intersect. Now we'll just do this one together, and then I'll give you one in a minute that you can try on your own, and we'll see how it goes. So we'll graph this one. It has a y-intercept of -2. We'll use the slope. Y-intercept of -2, the slope is -3/2, which means we're going to go to the right 2, and down 3. The negative slope means a negative rate, means like as we go right, it goes down, there's a decrease in the y-value. And I'll grab the line tool, go. Other one has a y-intercept of 3. A slope, what is the slope of this one?
1.
1 or even 1 over 1, if I want to see the horizontal and vertical. So it moves over 1 and up 1. Up line, back
line, go. Okay, and then just right there, that's where it converts. Like,
right there.
So 1, 2, 3. So it's three and one, -3 and 1.
I think you miscounted.
Oh.
Do you have to have the same point? Like, if you put it in, hold on, you can't. It's not open.
What's your question? If you're having trouble, you should probably stop working on your homework because you're not ready for it. Why don't you pay attention if you have questions? Pay attention to what we're doing. Okay? Where is this point?
What do you mean, like, what's it?
The coordinates of the point?
-2, 1.
-2, 1. Well, that's just where it looks like my lines cross.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think they cross at exactly
-2, 1?
No,
it could be any decimal.
Yeah, it might be any decimal. So how do we make sure that it is -2, 1?
Plug in
-2 for x in both these, 1 for y in both of these, make sure that it works. Do you think it would be very nice if I gave you an assignment where you had to graph it and the intersection was actually some decimal?
How would you put 1 in for y?
You just put 1 right there. There's y.
And test this, see if it's true.
Right.
And if it's not.
So put 1 in for y, -3/2 times -2 times 2. So 1 equals -3/2 times -2 is it's positive. 3. Positive 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 is 1. So confirmed. It is a solution to this equation. See if it's a solution to this equation. We'll put 1 there equals -2 plus 3. Be much easier than that, right? -2 plus 3 is 1.
Mm-hmm.
So check on that one. So that is a solution. Okay, we're not going to have graphs where it's some weird decimal. At most, it might be like a half, like cross at a half, something like that. But for the most part, these graphs are cross at pretty nice, like right on the grid places.
So, two questions. First, so like if you just have, for example, that one that you did y equals x plus 3, how did you like graph the point?
Well, I just did the y-intercept of 3, the slope of over 1 up 1, and then just drew the line.
Okay, and then for like making sure it's good, just find the slope for each one. Like
sure it's good.
To
never mind. But what happened if it?
What happens if we don't have the y-intercept?
Here's an example of where we didn't know the y-intercept. It was written in standard form. So you can plug a 0 in for x and a 0 in for y and find 2 points that way.
Well,
you could also rewrite it so that it's in slope-intercept form and then it will have the y-intercept.
Do you have a question?
Yep.
So does it have to equal 1 equals the answers over here? On this side is the equal sign, half the equal 1.
Mm-hmm. Well, since the y is 1, yes. That's the definition of the solution, is when I plug it into the equation, both sides are the same.
But what happens if it doesn't work then?
Then your graph maybe is a little bit off and you need to adjust. Okay.
I think it might be off or on. I was one way from it, but.
Mm. Alright, so here's one for you to try on your own. Try that one on your own, and then we'll see what we come up with. Okay, so these are both written nicely in slope-intercept form. See the intercept of 10, the slope of 4/3. I can't really go that way, so I'll go this way. 4/3, that would be to the left 3 and down 4. Second equation, -1 is the y-intercept, the slope is -1/2, so we'll go back 2 and up 1. And look at that, they cross right there, if you were to get right up on this graph of the board, okay, you would see it does, they do not cross right on this dot where they're supposed to be intersecting. Okay? Because you don't draw a graph for it, you know, exactly right. Well, where does it look like they should intersect? Where does it look like the solution should be? 60. Almost. -60. We always need to make sure. How do we make sure?
Plug it in.
But we're out of time, really, so plug it in. That's how it should look. When we graph them, we'll see the solution. What we're going to see tomorrow, Monday, is a more accurate, more elegant approach because, like I said, you don't draw graphs perfectly. So graphs are a terrible way to figure out that the solution is -6.2, 3.5.
Mm-hmm. That's not going to
work very well.
I'll
do
that later.
Do whatever you want me to do.
Hurry.